Parkinson's disease, what sort of the main thing that happens when you have Parkinson's disease, right, is that you lose dopamine slowly over time. And the whole idea of giving you medications for your Parkinson's disease is to counteract that. And so the main treatment that was discovered years and years and years ago is levodopa, carbidopa, levodopa, or cinnamet. And so what that does is when that levodopa gets into your system, gets into the brain, it gets converted to dopamine. But what happens is you might start on maybe one tablet three times a day, and as time goes on, as that Parkinson's progresses, it seems to just kind of tucker out a little bit more quickly than usual. And so you might get on this little roller coaster ride that Parkinson's patients end up getting on. It's called motor fluctuations. In other words, your motor symptoms are fluctuating throughout the day. And as time goes on, it happens more and more frequently, and then it happens more and more severely. And so you sort of oscillate between a very slow, stiff, tremulous state to one where you have more normal movement, and then you overshoot and you get into a more extra movement or dyskinetic state. And so that's sort of where deep brain stimulation comes into play, is when that roller coaster ride becomes pretty intolerable for you. So as Dr. Burchell mentioned, this is a delivery of high frequency stimulation to the brain that to an area of the brain that's dysfunctional. And so the idea is to provide more normal movement. So when should we do this? So this is sort of the treatment continuum for Parkinson's disease. So as you start out, you get your first diagnosis, we have to find two of these three symptoms, slowness, stiffness, or tremor. We might start you on a couple of different types of medications. As time goes on, we might add in levodopa. You're starting to have some wearing off. You're starting to get some dyskinesias, and then as advanced Parkinson's disease happens, more of the midline stuff happens, more falls, postural instability, cognitive issues. And so historically, we had done deep brain stimulation as sort of this last resort treatment of motor symptoms. So right on this edge between when people would get really troublesome dyskinesias, but before they get to what we would call advanced Parkinson's disease, because it's brain surgery, right? Let's try everything we can do with medications first before going to brain surgery. Well, over time we became better at doing brain surgery, and as Dr. Burchell is showing you, we've even moved that further to it being a much safer procedure. Additionally, we kind of know this trajectory. We understand that this is what happens over time. And so we're pulling this back. This is not a last case scenario. This is not a we've run out of options type of a therapy. Why not give you the benefit of this therapy a little bit earlier on? And so there's some clinical trials that show that doing this a little bit earlier is probably a good idea. And so we consider it a little bit earlier. Now some people still say, I want to do everything possible to, you know, before I go through brain surgery. I had one patient who we had been asking, you know, for years and years, are you sure you don't want to do this? Are you sure you don't want to do this? And finally said, you know what, I'm ready. So we do the surgery. He comes out on the other side. His tremor is gone. He's a textbook case. And his wife said, knowing what you know now, don't you wish you would have done it 2 years ago? And he said, nope, I wasn't ready 2 years ago. So that decision making is very personal to the patient. What our job is to tell you when that window opens, but also when that window closes. There is a closure point. If we were to do surgery once that midline stuff happens, then we could probably make things worse. And so that's our job, is to assess when is a good time for surgery.